السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبيه ومصطفى وبعد. The glorious Quran, the most beautiful word, the word of Ar-Rahman, is full of guidance, but it also requires tadabbur in order to benefit out of it. It requires pondering upon its meaning in order to be rightly guided. For instance, I'm going to shed some light here on verse number 26, chapter number 24, or Surah An-Nur, the surah which is known as the Surah of the Light. In this surah, the Almighty Allah says, in ayah number 26, الخبيثات للخبيثين والخبيثون للخبيثات والطيبات للطيبين والطيبون للطيبات أولئك مبرؤون مما يقولون لهم مغفرة ورزق كريم. So, a lot of people ask, what does it mean that الخبيثات للخبيثين and الخبيثون للخبيثات. And if we understand the segment, then obviously it will be easy for us to understand the next segment, which is الطيبات للطيبين والطيبون للطيبات. And we cannot understand these two segments separately from the segment of أولئك مبرؤون مما يقولون. In brief, the interpretation of this particular verse can be summarized in two different opinions, major different opinions. The first one is describing the words and the actions as good or evil. So the Almighty says accordingly, الخبيثات, the good statements, the good sayings, I'm sorry, الخبيثات, the evil sayings, the evil actions, للخبيثين, would only come out of the mouth of the evil people. والخبيثون للخبيثات. الخبيثون, the evil people. What do you expect them to say? They must say خبيثات, bad words, bad actions. Accordingly, it will be easy for us to comprehend the following segment, which is الطيبات للطيبين والطيبون للطيبات. الطيبات then will be understood as the good statements, the good sayings, the good actions. للطيبين normally come from the mouth of the good people. And the good actions normally be done by the good people. والطيبون للطيبات. And the good people would say only what is good and do only what is good. Okay. This is the first interpretation. The second interpretation, which is the opinion of Imam Qurtubi and many others, that it refers to marriage. Marriage. And it doesn't necessarily mean that all the good people are married to good, all the good men are married to good women, or all the good women are married to good men. Rather, this is khabar, recommendation, like suggestion. Allah is suggesting, Allah is recommending that the good people to choose good women, to choose good spouses, and the good women to only choose good husbands. But those who would choose an evil woman or an adulteress to marry, they themselves are evil as well. So that will pour into the account of explaining the innocence of Aisha radiallahu anha. Because the Mufassirun, the interpreters of the Quran, said this ayah was revealed based on the event of Al-Afk, when Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, the head of the hypocrites, may Allah curse him, falsely accused Aisha radiallahu anha of being in an illicit relationship with a great companion named Safwan ibn Mu'attal, because she left the caravan upon their return to Medina when she answered the call of nature and she came, the caravan had left already. So Safwan ibn Mu'attal, who was in charge of guarding the caravan, found her asleep. So he made his camel kneel down and he said Subhanallah out loud. So Aisha woke up and he asked her, O mother of the believers, ride on the back of the camel. Then he drove her to catch up with the caravan. That's it. So Allah the Almighty revealed the innocence of Aisha radiallahu anha in 11 verses and Surah An-Nur, chapter number 24. Then he stated, according to the second meaning of Al-Khabithat wal-Khabithin, that if you find evil women, they will be married to evil men. And if you find evil men, they will be married to evil women. This is normal. They don't get along. The like birds fly together. But since Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the best of at-tayyibina, then all his spouses must be tayyibat. So those are the two meanings of al-khabithatu lil-khabithina والخبيثون للخبيثات والطيبات للطيبين والطيبون للطيبات. Good people would only choose to marry the like. Good men would only choose to marry good women. And good women would only agree to marry good men. And not the other way around. MashaAllah. Then Allah the Almighty stated, أولئك مبرؤون مما يقولون. Those people, referring to the good people like Aisha رضي الله عنها, are free from the evil sayings of those evil people, Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul and his like. لهم مغفرة ورزق كريم. For the good people, like Aisha radiallahu anha, the good spouses, and obviously, the best of at-tayyibin is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his entire family. لهم مغفرة ورزق كريم. For them, there will be a forgiveness from the Lord and a noble provision. Brothers and sisters, here the Almighty Allah is also guiding us. When you choose a spouse, make sure it is not only for pleasure. Choose somebody who will be the father or the mother of your future children. Okay? Parenting is something really important. So don't only think about marrying somebody because of her beauty or marrying a man because he is rich, because he's handsome. You gotta search deeper. You gotta make sure that this person is religiously committed, is a man of honor, is a woman who preserves Allah's huquq and adab, and so on. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to what is best, and may He enable us to understand His word, ponder over their meaning, and act upon them. Ameen. Till next time, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.